Hi, how's everybody doing today? We're out here practicing again.
Hey, Ashley, Joshua, we started playing a couple weeks ago. So how long have you been playing? Yeah, we're fine. Here we go. So we're hitting and trying to get better. That's an overhead, Joshua. We're fine. Anyway,
I've been playing with the Wilson Profile, the 95 square inch, and this is a Kruber, a coupler, I'm sorry, K-U-E, how do you spell it, it's a K-U-E-B-L-E-R, Kubler, or coupler, and I've been playing with these rackets. These are the first edition. They're from Germany, and I've been getting them for about $35, $40. So this one was strong by the person who sold it to me. I'm gonna try it, but I got three of them. And no matter what rackets you play with, I always suggest that you get three or four of the same, and have them strong different tensions. And that way you get an idea how to hit the ball. But I don't hit with a lot of top spin, but I'm teaching these guys and my wife and Joshua how to hit with modern spin and stuff.
Here you go, bud.
We're playing Australian doubles. You get to use both forks. So, pretty cool. Feel a little better. I got this knee brace to help me with my knees. These hard courts are horrible. Let's go. Good job, buddy. Just a bit outside.
I'm going to wrap it here.
just a bit outside. Tried to corner on that one. Ball eight.
What? Let's get the ball come. Turn. Hit. Nice.
So deep pockets. You put like 10 balls in these pockets here.
Buddy,
that's how it's done. You see how you hit through it though?
You hit through the ball, the body, the leg. Sorry. Well, I'm trying to hit the top spin for you guys. Sorry.
Actually, three of these rackets for her to start off with. They're lower end Wilsons, but the wrap on her is too much. It's a 4.5. She needs a 4.25 or 4.375 grip. I use a 4.5, just regular, no over grip, unless it's unless somebody took the wrap off of the original and made it bad. But these are nylon strings. These are trash.
Go ahead, babe. Let's go. No. You can hit the ball. Good try, baby. Good try. Yeah, buddy.
long, you get a rapid on it. You bounce the ball and play. Here, folks, having some fun though. That's what it's about. Bad. We're not doing bad though, because seeing everybody just started playing tennis. I haven't played in 25 years. So I think we're doing great. Plus, there's no room for negativity out here.
Cool. I'm gonna try a couple throws. Thank you.
normally it would go down the middle of the peak.
What's that one over here? That much blue, bro. Well, it's got a wall to it.
Working on kick serves with these wide body rackets because I gotta get used to hitting with it again. And you can see some of the shots. I'm nowhere near what happens, but just getting your feet moving, folks.
Thank you.
My style of play is changing, and I'm probably just gonna end up playing doubles.
There you go.
But I gotta serve volley. Okay, honey, thank you.
Sorry. Watch out for her. move that left hand chip you're doing and hit the ball with a one hand like that or with both hands. You'll get a lot more, ball if you're faster. Use the left hand. At least you're developing it, but right now. That's what's up. That's why I'm trying to teach you fundamental strokes. Just the fundamental. Ball come, turn, hit. I keep my feet straight and then lift up. I have to hit the ball from the floor. When it's up in the air and I have to hit through it. But most of the time, besides the feet work, you gotta get better at the way your sets are. Sorry, that was cracked. Way better, dude. That ball's gonna bounce high. Put Thompson on it. That's hard to change your hands like that. Here you go. Sorry. Good shot. Beautiful shot. Beautiful shot. Good job.
You think gonna be able to do that consistently? Mini game time. Mini tennis.
Who's first?
You guys. Yeah, you guys play first.
I will win.
There you go. Get some balls. Get you some water. You should drink a lot of water. It's hot out here.
Not that bad out there.
I know, I'm sweating. I bought some bananas too, folks.
I'll serve first.
Well, technically, you're supposed to flip a coin to see who's so short, or you spin the butt of your racket like I taught you, and P will be up and D will be down. But, you know, we're just doing friendly times, but normally you'll spin the racket like those in the
Josh, you
want to
serve first? Yes or no?
Yeah,
okay, here you go. That's what he's going to serve first.
It's very high out here, folks, and I suggest always bring water with you, and you're drinking a lot of water. So Ashley's been playing tennis for about 3 weeks. Josh has been playing for about 4 or 5 days, about 3 or 4 days. And what I do when people are learning and never played tennis before is we do mini tennis. You cut the court in half, you play a game like a regular game, and I play pro set, eight games, okay? And we use the add and the deuce and play the games out. And that way, the person learns how to play the game and they learn how to direct the ball and, you know, use more delicate because they can't whack it and it go all over the place. Although, you know, you're gonna lose points because you're gonna be, you know, in the wrong areas, but it makes you play harder. But it's basically, you wanna have fun. You wanna teach the person the rules of the game, how to hold the tennis racket correctly, how to step into the ball, just basic stuff, and the serve, throwing the ball up to high enough to where you hit it. And then once you get the basics down, then you develop your own style and how you want to do stuff. But there's always the fundamentals of continental grip on serves, just the way it does it. And some people I've seen switch their hand to Eastern grip, like a forehand grip on their serves, for flat serves. Which you can do that, but it's hard to hit spin with the Eastern grip as with serve. So it's easier to hit use the continental grip for the serves. That way, when you're serving and the ball comes back to you, you're also in the volley grip too, because that's what the grip you would use for continental is for volleying also. And a lot of people think that you have to swing hard at the volleys, which you want to do at volleying. In my experience and being around really good players, and I've seen a lot of people play live, and I've seen a lot of people practice. And one of my friends growing up, that my coach, Rick Bowerson, he taught me how to play tennis correctly. And he was a pitcher for the New York Yankees back in the day. And he was friends with a lot of these dudes, Connors and McEnroe. And I seen McEnroe play over at Key Biscayne at the Lipton. He was practicing. At the end of his career, he was practicing with a bunch of, Aaron Crick's team was there, Jimmy Connors was there, Boris Becker, and some other fellas, Guy Forget, and there was a few fellas, and they were all practicing on the courts, doing, volleying back and forth and stuff, and McEnroe's hands were so phenomenal. Every ball that came to him, it would just blink it back because his rackets are strung so loose, so he can feel the ball, and that's what you want to do when you're volleying. You want to absorb the ball, you know. And it's nice to hit with a lot of excessive topspin. If you see how I hit, I mean, I haven't played in 25 years, and once I get my timing and everything back, the balls I hit are very flat, semi, like a little bit of topspin. I can hit with topspin, but when I'm playing tournaments, and I'm going to play, if I was playing singles or doubles, whatever, and these folks now with this new style play with all this excessive topspin, it's going to set up perfect for me, for my wheelhouse to hit the ball flat. Because the reason why these people can track these balls down is because no one's putting any flat ball, making the ball hit flatter to cut the time off for them to get to the ball. And it make it harder for them to get the ball off the ground with topspin because it'll be low and flat and on the lines. So that's how I'm going to have to play anyway, because I've had 2 surgeries on my hips, 2 hip replacements, a plate in my shoulder, and I have back and neck injuries. So if I start playing in tournaments, I'm going to have to shorten the games and play a little differently than I normally would have played back when I was a youngster and playing in tournaments. So everything's timing, it's your footwork and speed. You need to be able to move in tennis, and that's what I'm working on. And by the way, if you guys need those little cones, those little emergency cones that you see people training with, you can get them at the Dollar Tree. I got a bunch of them, and I'm going to show you some drills that I'll be doing And I learned some drills from Nick on intuitive tennis also. So I knew some drills from before. Thanks, honey.
Okay.
And then I knew some drills from before, and then I found some new ones. So okay. Thanks, honey. All right, we'll do mini tennis.
Mini tennis is fun. Woo! Turn the lights on.
Okay. Tennis is a game, is a social game, and you're supposed to have fun. And no matter what, you're supposed to just have fun. Enjoy it.
You want to start first, baby? That slice and moved it over. Point off. I framed it.
That's game.
I framed it. I got a plastic thumb shot. I don't want to feel like going to whack the ball. I like to practice something. I play doubles Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Good. Nice serve. Thank you.
points, this would be game point for you.
40-30. 30-40.
Serve. 540. That was a nice serve, bud.
Up on the point, even though somebody looks like he's out, keep an eye on the ball. See, that got you back in the game. Now it's 30-40. You hit a good shot, buddy. I hit it right back to you, and you hit it in the open court. Great job.
Up in the air. You gotta hit it. Yeah, I can't.
just put it on the table. Take your hand and roll it all the way down. That's how you want to hit the ball. See? You're doing the top roll over. Practice doing that. And when you're playing, you're hitting it up like this, which is what you're attacking. You pull your racket and use the same swing. 30-40. Yes, sir. Play a game, you don't want to tee off on every shot. I am practicing some shots, but that was a nice serve for you. Go ahead, two things. Buddy.
How you ending over there?
Practicing my serve.
There you go. Hey, okay, you're there. Okay. Okay, well, 15. Nice job, buddy.
Catch it.
No, don't hold the camera.
Good. It's dangerous out here, folks.
Danger.
Oh, You try. Here you go, buddy. Almost. That was just aggressive. Yeah, you really got a hold of that one. There's a hole in the racket. I didn't miss your mine too.
I went way over.
I gotta send my racket back. I got a big old hole in the racket. Every time I gotta hit the ball, it's gonna break through the racket. Ball over here. The hell going on out there? I'm ready to stick again. Hey, boy. Hey, Chuck. You hit through the ball, you hit a great serve. That was good stuff, buddy. Good stuff.
Thank you.
now. So 5 minutes till 8 o'clock.
What time did we get here?
47.
Before 7, right?
Yeah, it was before 7.
Okay. You got a ball?
Yeah, I do. I want that. Well done. Well done, baby. Well done. That's what's up. I'm going to try to hit the picture of these fly rackets. Good try. That's like a fight. Look, the balls are so far. It's hard to see how you can actually hit the ball. The ball's really flat. And I'm playing with dead strings. I'm not complaining. I just know which one things I gotta fix. I'm gonna go out wide. Throw the ball up higher, Sean. Ball with a cotton nail grip, and that's good. You gotta get used to it, that's all, buddy.
much better slicing it, but hit, you're hitting slice too low. That's what you're doing. That's how you're doing. You gotta, if you're gonna hit that, if you're gonna hit that slice, you gotta hold that button in the grip. And you gotta keep your eye on the ball and hold the ball in front of you.
So you toss up high enough so it gives you some chance to hit the ball. It's a taller fella. Use your height. Give yourself some time to hit the ball.
Go ahead.
Snapping your wrist. When you see when you, this is the line. You stand like this. Your feet balanced. You stand like that. A little sideways if you want. However you feel comfortable. But you have to have your feet in a position where you can walk backwards and forwards and bring your weight back and then hit through it. That's off the top of the thing. But when I serve like this, it's relaxing. You gotta get it in a rhythm. That's why we're out here practicing. Yeah, they're pens. Baby. Good plan. Yeah. You know, a little bad. What would you think? Where would you think? I guess how good they are.
I would say put them in the thing
for
the coming
right. Okay. Good. Yeah, that's cool.
No, I want to just catch this ball. Oops.
confusing as hell with the way you guys do business out here.
I think you're good.
That's a special rocket, so you're meaning your chance to hit with something that's a little different. My original bag I've had for a long time, quite a couple decades actually. So it carries up to about 10 tennis rackets really. I have three profiles and a 110 profile, 2.7, or actually I think it's a 2.7, but, and I also got a Prince comp and the Wilson hammer. But I use the profiles, and we had a good time today, so I appreciate everybody watching. I know it's a long video, but I wanted to let everybody know this is what the kind of stuff we do on a Saturday night. We come out here, get some tennis time, and spend some time with our family, and enjoy some sports and get in shape. Like I say, I was at 225. I'm at 205 right now, and I've lost 20 pounds. And I'm gonna be down to 175 by December to get in tournament shape, and we're gonna get there. So it's all fun. I appreciate everybody watching, and thank you for joining me on this tennis journey. And I wanted to give a shout out to Intuitive Tennis, Nick over there, and Tyler. That guy's does tennis too. And then there's this Wu fella. He does tennis. He does like tournaments and plays other people and stuff. So there's a few people I've been watching, and they're really nice people, and they got good channels. But Intuitive Tennis, as I said, I think that he's a really good coach. He's a good trainer, and it's a gift God gave him. So he's really good at it, and the videos he makes is really good. So I appreciate everybody watching. Thank you very much, and God bless everybody.